Hi everyone, welcome to Standard Share. So in this video we are going to see what is expected tomorrow and what are the inside camera loss stocks which are in radar for tomorrow and how can we go for a trade with all those. So that is what we are going to see in this video. So whatever analysis shared in this video is all my analysis, my knowledge, so I can be wrong at any place. So please use your own knowledge, own analysis, own strategy and also play with proper risk management. Please do not blame me for your profits and loss. A strict disclaimer is applicable. Clear? So moving on to the video further, on yesterday's video itself I have told like what is expected in Nifty, what is the positional view I have in Nifty, and I hope people are like more interested or people have already known about what is happening in HDFC Nifty. So there is a nearly 250 points fall has been seen in HDFC Nifty, and also the low has formed is 16,236, which is actually 300 plus points fall has been seen in HDFC Nifty. Thank God today there is no market and the market is holiday, otherwise we would have everyone would have been like scared and not sure like what to do. And there will be like one question like what will happen tomorrow, whether we will still face a gap down or what would happen. We are not sure because still the US market has started but has not closed. So we might like HDFC might recover. We are not exactly sure like what can happen. But let us see what is expected tomorrow. What are the possible levels which can be applicable or which is possible. So going with the tomorrow CPR and Camarilla. So tomorrow CPR and Camarilla looks, the CPR looks overlapping higher value. See over here, the CPR looks overlapping higher value, but the Camarilla looks overlapping lower value. So I would take the view of Camarilla. Why? Because it's like, though the CPR is having a overlapping higher value CPR, but if you see the candle, the yesterday's candle has closed below tomorrow's starting of the CPR. So tomorrow's CPR is over here, but the candle's close is below the candles, the CPR. So I would prefer it as a bearish opportunity only. And also what I would say is like the H3 is between the CPR, so we might expect if any pullback towards the CPR is going to be a shorting opportunity. But again, we might expect we might open a gap down also. So whenever we are opening gap down, so make sure that where is the rejection zone, how is the rejection zones are happening, and based on that try to make a trade out of that. Clear? And also one more point I wanted to say over here is check for virgin CPR zones and let's see whether market can rest over here. So approximately this is the virgin CPR zone and this is also virgin CPR zone. So virgin CPR zone is coming around 16,240 to 16,270, and let us see where HDFC Nifty low is there, 16,236. So exactly it has come to the virgin CPR zone. So if suppose market is going to open a huge gap up, then it might take some support at the virgin CPR zone and then start to move upside, or we might able to see some flat opening and then a drop down to the virgin CPR as well. We are not exactly very sure like what would happen tomorrow, but as per the analysis of CPR and Camarilla, as we have closed below the CPR and the Camarilla is also in a bearish bias, I'm expecting a bearish move in Nifty. If in case the candles are opening above the CPR, and then any pullback towards CPR will be a buying opportunity. Until and unless it is not closing above the CPR or opening above the CPR, it is going to be a bearish opportunity only. And based on the HDFC Nifty fall, I'm expecting that it might take some support over here, and that is what is shown now. And as I said in yesterday's video as well, the positional view of Nifty I told was like 16,300 is far now the positional view which was possible, and exactly the same has happened. Clear? And now moving on to the option chain analysis. So let us see what option chain analysis is also saying. So for, we have to go for the month end expiry. So 26th August 2021. So for the month end expiry, I could see that the highest OA contracts is at 68,771 and it is around 17,000 CE. So this will act as a good resistance. And at the PE side, what I would see is like 91,000 is showing some PE, so this will be acting as a good support, 16,500. But what would happen tomorrow is like we might open a gap down and all the OA changes might change, OA data might change with the once the market opened. I don't see any signaling of like market would open down or gap down with respect to the OA what I see now. So let us see what is going to happen. Now let us go for Bank Nifty. Clear? And Bank Nifty, So this is the Bank Nifty chart. Bank Nifty is clearly bearish. I said that yesterday itself, Bank Nifty has closed below the Tuesday's low. So I was expecting bearish, and I told a huge fall of 33,000 is also possible in Bank Nifty. That was my expectation in Bank Nifty. Now, anyways, let us see what is with respect to CPR and Camarilla. Both will show bearishness only. Yeah, both is showing bearishness, and also the CPR is very wide. Even the Camarilla is also very wide. So I'm expecting some sort of range bound scenario in Bank Nifty. Range bound scenario in the sense it might open a gap down and then it might just consolidate. So that is what my expectation in Bank Nifty for tomorrow. But in the case of Nifty, Nifty is showing a lot of signs of bearishness, and it can trend as well. So we need to wait and watch on how Nifty and Bank Nifty is opening. And with respect to Camarilla, with respect to option chain, so around 56,829 contracts is seen at 36,000 CE. So this will act as a good resistance. And for PE side, 40,000 contracts is seen around 35,000 PE, and this will act as a good support. So for now, 35,000 is going to be the good support, and 36,000 is going to be the good resistance. And let's forget about SGX for now. The low was 16,236, and now it is trading at 16,323. If Dow is going to close positive, then we might also recover in this. So forget about this, concentrate on the opening of the candle from tomorrow, and based on the opening of the candle, decide how we can go for a trade. Clear? So now let us move on to the inside Camarilla analysis. So inside Camarilla, we have 16 stocks: Hindustan Unilever, Infosys, Mahindra & Mahindra, TCS, Tech Mahindra, and UPL. I could see like three stocks based on or out of IT, and one is FMCG, and one is auto, and all those. Okay. So I would say prefer trading on the inside Camarilla stocks based on the breakout or breakdown or taking support or rejection. So this is what the area you need to concentrate. Let us quickly see where actually the overall trend is all about. Clear? So the overall trend in Hindustan Unilever is at the all-time resistance zone. So this, it was like good in a good consolidation zone actually it was forming. And it is having some sort of pattern as well. So what I would expect is like only if it is able to give a breakout above this zone, it can move further. Otherwise, it can face some rejection and come down. So what is that doji sort of candle has been seen. So if it is opening above this candle, then we might expect some sort of upside move. If it is not opening above the upside, then check how the low is getting broken. So based on that, you need to consider the trade on that. Clear? And now let us go to Mahindra & Mahindra. Mahindra & Mahindra trend is also not that great. If you see, it is also in a consolidation, forming a sort of pattern only in Mahindra & Mahindra. So in the short term trend, it is showing some sort of bearishness. It is showing some sort of bullishness. From here, it has taken support, and it has like 2 to 3 days of consolidation is also seen. So we might, if I'm not sure, like I'm expecting some upside move only. So I'm expecting like if it is breaking 804, it can still go further upside, like 820 levels and 840, 850 levels is what is expected. But as market is going to open gap down, you need to wait and watch and see how Mahindra & Mahindra is going to react. What I would say is, like as I said earlier, the trend is sideways, but short term, like say 2 to 3 weeks, trend is like bullish. I would say wait for either breakout or support or what is actually happening in the intraday chart. So based on that, try to take a trade. Clear? And the next stock is Infosys TCS. Infosys, okay, it is neat uptrend, but sort of a wick reversal setup is seen at the top of the candle, or the top of the chart. So you need to wait and watch. If it is closing below and we are able to give a get a good breakdown, then it might fall a bit around at least 1700, or we could see 1686 also. But watch carefully on how it is performing. Even I think TCS, Techem, all will be having the same view. Yeah, at the top of the trend, they are trying to put a reversal sign. So we are not exactly very sure whether that is a reversal sign or how is that going to happen. And here, same way, if it is going to give a close above the all-time high, then it can further move up. If it is not, and if it is like going to give a close below, then it is a sort of a reversal trade which we are going to take. So watch carefully whether it is going to take a support or whether it is going to break down. And I would always say that wait and catch the trade with a proper risk reward ratio. Clear? And next stock is UPL. UPL, basically, I avoid this stock because it shows a lot and lot of volatility, and that is why I avoid this stock. And this stock, I would say that an inside bar is also seen, an inside camera law is also seen. Market might open gap down, so that time it might also open low. And if you guys also see over here, lot of wicks, and this is why this I avoid this stock. It is highly volatile stock. I don't prefer trading in UPL. So just concentrate on the other stocks and see which one is giving a good sign and which one is giving a good risk reward ratio to go and take for a trade. Clear? So this is all about the analysis which I wanted to share in with respect to Nifty, Bank Nifty, and as well as the inside camera law stocks. If you have any other queries, do let me know in the comment section. Or if you guys are expecting any other views, like you guys need swing trades view, or you guys need intraday view, or you guys need only strategy explanations, please do let me know in the comment section so that I'll start making those types of videos as well. Clear? So that's it from my end. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.